Are you all ready for this map pool showcase?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we have our Springtime Osumania free-for-all tournament to qualifiers for week 2 map pool. As you've all heard all the seed announcements, you're all aware of everyone's standings and are probably gearing up for practice for the next weekend that's upcoming.
Unless you're in the top 16, of course.
Well, yeah, unless you're in the top 16. Well, we do have a good set of maps coming into you. It's pretty much a full map pool. 9 maps plus a tiebreaker. So, let's see. I'm not actually sure how long we're going to wait before we actually get started. However, I believe we're all ready to go. Yep, and it looks like they're going to be heading right into this first song, which, as you can probably hear, is After. This is Grun's 4K HD map. It's a pretty short song, only 125 in length, but it is pretty fast, 185, with a star rating of 3.24.
So it's definitely going to be a speed pick for anybody that's that has that skill set sort of catered towards them. Bit of trills here that might trick a couple players up.
Yeah, the one-handed trills could have a lot of players dropping in accuracy on this song.
Other than that, there's a couple sections here that, like now, that just came up with the split jump trills.
Yeah, those split jump trills will definitely trip up some of the players, especially in terms of just holding overall accuracy.
So this is kind of that, I wouldn't say generic, but just normal stream chart that players might have wished for during the qualifiers that could have benefited them some more.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of players are looking at this like, why couldn't we have this? Why couldn't we have had this?
Definitely like a heaven almost for some players.
Gotta love that star rating inflation with jump trolls, though.
Yeah, definitely. Looking like a rank chart here, really.
Yeah. I believe it is ranked, potentially? I don't actually know. Juan Crystal absolutely demolishing T-Deck. Whoops!
Goodbye, T-Deck. Tell you what, this is ranked. That is a ranked chart. That is, yeah.
Makes sense. Anyways, we'll head into our second pick, or our second map of the map pool, Korobushka, the Ryu mix. Let's see. This one is our first LN chart of the pool.
Actually, top 50 on After are all double S's, so potentially could see some coming out, or at least some very high accuracy scores coming out from players, at least during soft on score B2.
That is a good point. I think even though it's not for anyone above top 16 isn't actually playing, there's so much potential for that double S coming in, and I feel for a lot of this map pool too.
Absolutely, especially when you see that some of the people who just barely made top 128 were people who just only screwed up on coinage and had 90k on charts like Mangekyo.
Definitely, and I have never seen this map, so all I know is long notes.
Yeah, so there's a lot of long notes here, long and short, that might be hard to time correctly.
It looks simple enough because there's no complex release points. It's all the next release points comes when the previous long note ends.
Yeah, definitely. Starts.
So yeah, the map looks fairly simple, at least so far.
For now, yeah.
I'm guessing it's going to pick up in the second half, though.
Most likely. So for now, just basic LNs, and I know that there are some people that were not really happy with the even with basic LNs in the qualifier map pool, so this might not necessarily be a pick for them.
Well, yeah, but there will be a full pick fan phase, so yeah. Ooh, this is where I think people might start getting tripped up on the LNs with...
Yeah, this is a bit more complex part with normal rice and noodles, for lack of a better term.
Couple yeah, the density is definitely picking up now. Some same-handed rice noodles as well. And here's the Silver Temple long notes. One crystal at the break. Wow, actually very similar scores coming up from both players, both hitting the same
amount of 300s. And just one off on the perfect 300s.
Wonder what one crystal has to say about that. He says, why did I miss? Anyways, our third map, Metal Scratchin'. This map is by Zio Style.
And just a little hint here, Electric Sound Lab was also by Zio Style, so hopefully you can guess what kind of chart this is going to be.
I'm really excited to see what this one has in store.
I remember a round of, I believe it was 64, that Electric Sound Lab really tricked me up, so I'm just going to say this again and again, you need to prepare. You need to prepare these apples.
I mean, I think everyone who played in the qualifiers kind of gets a sense for it with coinage being out there. I mean, you're going to need to put practice into the map while you're going to need to look at all the maps, or else you're going to be sight reading things.
Yeah, definitely. But...
is this a good background?
Oh no, I played this game when I was like 7, oh my god.
It's been a while.
Yeah.
Oh my god, that beatbox.
Well, here comes the fun part.
Those are learnable after a couple plays.
Yeah, I would honestly say listen to the song a bit, because I think that'll definitely help. Seems like a pretty straightforward beat that you can sort of play on, or how would I say it? Orally, I guess, off of?
Orally?
Yeah, sure.
I think this is actually one of the more sight-readable SV maps, because you still are able to process the gaps between notes.
Yeah, really, and also, like, you can really quickly pick up on a feel for the song.
It looks like there are a couple different patterns of SVs, so it's not just going to be, definitely a couple different patterns of SVs that occur in this song. So it's not going to be a song that you're able to zone out on at all. You're still going to have to pay a lot of attention, even if you've learned this song thoroughly.
And for those who aren't able to learn a song like this, don't worry. You have your ban, and feel free to use it on this chart or any other SV fix that could potentially come up. I love his background so much.
Gotta go fast.
Really gotta go. Gotta go, trying to think of a word that would describe SVs, but nothing's coming ahead to my mind.
Gotta go suddenly fast.
There you go. Alright, I might have to scratch the metal instead of dropping coins for this one.
Oh, I think they played the wrong difficulty. Oh. They played the wrong difficulty. Okay, so for all of you who are watching wondering if maybe the difficulty was too hard, this is actually... they played the harder chart. So,
what's that going to redo this one?
You'll be playing? Are they going to redo this one?
I probably would. They probably should anyway.
They might redo it, just to showcase the actual difficulty of the song.
Yeah.
I did notice that, like, those split patterns were quite a bit harder than the first song in the map pool. And yes, they are switching to the purple difficulty, which is the one that's actually going to be used in the map pool. Take note.
So anybody that's practicing this map pool, don't play the blue difficulty.
the purple. Yeah, multiple songs in this map will have many difficulties, so make sure you are practicing the correct one. I think in terms of, like, the spread of players throughout this tournament, this map isn't necessarily hard. However, in comparison to the previous map showcased, it was a little bit more difficult compared to the other ones in terms of, I guess, node density. There was an overuse of hands and a lot of split patterns. Yeah, and instead of being really split-heavy jump trill type patterns, this is looking a lot less dense, a lot more single notes.
I think this one's a lot more focused on the SBs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it looks like a lot more patterns are just focused on two-hand trilling type things, so pretty easy to keep your accuracy up as long as you can make it through those SBs. Oh, that mini jack could be really brutal if you're actually not ready for it.
So this chart still might actually trip up a few sight readers.
Potentially. It's still decently... I say decently, but it's still fairly slow in comparison to the other song. It's only 140 BPM.
I feel like the SBs in this are a bit more tricky than the blue diff. It's just that the other non-SB parts aren't as dense.
Like, that mini jack, I think, isn't present in the blue difficulty at the end of some of these SVs. Looks like T-Deck still wrecks one crystal. T-Deck double S's, okay.
On the SB pick, though, so somewhat understandable.
V1 double S, that's true. Anyways, our fourth pick, our fourth song in this map pool is Umeyukiyo, a Crispy Joy Box song by, I actually don't know who this step artist or this mapper is. Oh, well. Didn't list it.
I don't think I pronounced
Okazaki that. Ushio, there we go. It's right there. So another decently length song at 1 minute 43 seconds, 167 BPM star rating of 2.78. Debit 13 already orgasming in chat about how he loves the chart. Claiming that this is an accuracy pick. Also, fairly technical, switching in between different snaps, causing you to kind of focus on your accuracy to really keep it up.
So I guess it's comparable to Mangekyo in a way.
I think a fair bit slower.
Slightly, yeah.
Yeah, those little roll bursts might trip up players if they don't start and end them at the correct time in order to actually accuracy them completely properly.
I remember seeing a lot of players in Silver Temple actually really like rushing the rolls badly, so something that people might need to practice there.
Switching in between those 12th notes as well, instead of just straight 16ths, or I guess 1/4.
Bit of a tricky section there, possibly, if players aren't really paying attention. A couple mini jacks up here, that's a bit surprising.
I think those are technically full jacks with the 3 notes.
Oh. Gotta get my terminology right.
I believe mini jacks are referred to when you have 2 notes in a row.
Yeah.
I think, though, if jacks are at an appropriate speed for a player, they're very, very easy to accuracy. Otherwise, you're basically praying that you can hit them at the proper speed.
Yeah, I felt with Jax that it's more of like you can either play them and just
look at the scores.
Wow. Okay.
202 points.
Neck and neck here. Like with Jax, I felt that it really depends on what you can play, and if you can play a certain speed, you're just kind of already able to hit it with good accuracy as well.
Yep. And onto our fifth map of the pool, we got Eastward by Kinkiha. This is a Rizqi map. Actually, this is One's map, technically.
Technically.
2 minutes and 3 seconds in length, 186 beats per minute, star rating of 3, exactly.
So similar to the BPM of our first pick after, so definitely another speed kind of pick here.
Believe it's short and fast jump stream patterns.
Probably will cater to the same people who would want to pick a chart like after.
Probably. I don't think this is going to be banned, like, at all, I think.
Yeah, I mean, this is probably one of the bigger picks here.
Mm-hmm.
I know also, a lot of people have been wanting a lot more straightforward charts here, so...
Yep, well, here you go. We got a little bit of respite before we get back into the fun stuff. Also, to those people who are asking in chat, I believe in the qualifier round, or qualifier stage 2, these matches will be best of 7. So you have 9 songs in the map pool, 2 will be banned out. And then, yeah, you play 6 maps. If both of you win 3, then you play the tiebreaker instead.
So if it does get to tiebreaker, I'm pretty sure you would play everything besides charts that people ban.
Well, there's 9. If 2 are banned, then there's going to be 7.
So
which means you'll play 6. Though. You'll play minus 1. Ooh. These long notes might trip up some players if they're not ready for them. They have a little bit shorter releases than normal.
Those two small LNs there. Definitely a bit tricky.
Yeah, and I think for the majority of the players, especially in the upper echelon of this qualifier round, are going to consider this an accuracy pick still, and not necessarily a speed pick, I don't think.
It's a couple small rolls here and there, but nothing too special. Scores are flickering a lot here. I think they have the exact same accuracy.
Potentially. Who's gonna take it? Oh, the song's not even over. I thought it was just gonna be over with that verse. Looks like T-Dex edging it out.
No, there's still
no one crystal.
Oh, wow. T-Dex actually dropping 200 at the very last LM there.
But yeah, I think this song is very straightforward for what it's worth.
But just in the very end, Juan actually taking it.
Mm-hmm.
0-200s.
Double S, worst ratio. Still takes the win. Good score, V1. Well,
quote-unquote double S and score V2.
Alright, so we have to watch out a little bit because this next pick is called Flicker by Paul
and
Robinson.
It's also...
This is a Hydria map.
Yeah, difficulty name also kind of gives a bit away.
Ooh, what does that difficulty name? I think it says SV Heaven, potentially. I wonder what this is going to be about.
I think people will think of it as SV Hell.
SV Heaven or SV Hell.
According to the map pool selectors, this is the predicted number one band choice.
Oh boy.
Supposedly harder to learn than Metal Scratchin', so we'll see what this has to offer.
I'm excited.
Yeah, me too, really.
Also, fairly decent in length, 239. It's very slow, though. 92 BPM, star rating of 2.66.
So, if anyone's wondering, yes, this is an SB pick, meaning there are 2 SB charts in the map pool that you do need to learn. Unless
with those shutters.
No! That really caught me off guard.
Oh, these little gallops are going to be tricky for a lot of players, I think. Ooh, this little slowdown screws up one crystal. But T-Deck is one of the Maple Selectors. Oh, okay. Wow. Okay.
I think I see myself banning this personally. I'm just off the other charts that have been shown right now.
I mean, the thing
for
is
sure that this is definitely hard to learn the Metal Scratch in. Especially for that... LN.
Yeah. I was gonna say, if you think it's worth putting in the work and saving your ban in hopes that maybe the other player will use up their ban, actually banning this, that's also, I guess, a legit strategy.
It could work in your favor if you also have this practice, because, you know, this is a map that I'm guessing a lot of people will just ban out. And
slow
if you have
jam,
practice, yeah, really. But if the other person doesn't actually ban this chart and you haven't practiced, then you might just have an advantage right off the bat.
I think what's interesting about this song is that the SVs aren't necessarily natural, I don't think. And what I mean by that is that you can't look at it and know exactly where the SVs are going to occur. They're kind of... they surprise you!
Yeah.
Oh.
I'll say this is a straightforward part up here, but the SVs just are so unexpected.
I think, yeah, okay. Right there. The yeah. Second you let your guard down, it will punch you in the face. Oh,
jeez.
Man, those are very close to something, very close to, like, needing to be memorized almost. Depending on your speed mod, like if you're at way too high a speed mod, you're not going to be able to read those jumps.
Well, your name's Commando Black, you should have no problem.
And the thing is that if you do lower your reading scroll speed, you also have to consider the slowdown or the slow jam in the middle of this song. And with the slowdown.
That was very rude.
Both of the slowdowns nailed one crystal.
The song is, like, getting quieter, but the SVs just get worse in the end.
Yeah, I can definitely see that being banned a lot by very many players. Also, if you were looking at the long notes, a lot of them had, like, slightly shorter cutoffs than the next note, so you do have to be paying attention to those as well. There's just a lot going on that you'll have to work on if you do plan on picking this map ever.
I'd also like to point out that despite the actual showcase showing the chart from Hydra's map pack, that he also has a solo upload of this, so you don't actually have to download the entire map pack if you so choose.
Yeah, we'll have a separate packaging when the whole map pool download link goes out for all of you to download at your convenience. Download the map pool. Do not sight read this map pool.
Or at the very least, if you're going to sight read, ban this, because you're not going to do good.
Well, up next, they haven't selected it yet, but
it's
everyone's favorite artist. There we go. Exactly what I was going to say.
I guess this being the artist, it does make sense that the chart is a bit more of a technical pick.
A little bit. Such a the shortest song in the map pool, I believe?
Looks like it, yeah.
Well, by like... No, actually, no. The first song was 125.
Mm-hmm.
This map isn't very large.
This is just 2 seconds shorter than Metal Scratchin'.
Yeah, and Metal Scratchin' was 136. Which gives you the time, how long it is. You could probably figure out the artist after knowing the time now is 1 minute and 34 seconds.
Cough, cough. Oh man, these guys are changing the map.
Who makes really short songs that everyone loves? RIP, it's Camellia. Also, I got it in Twitch chat. Anyways, the song is Mushi no Sumu Tokoro. This is Pook's HD. But yeah, as you can probably hear from just the way the song is going, this is a very technical chart. It pretty much features like everything. Bursts, a little bit of quick streams, long note streams, and some variable snaps. And guess what? it really is an all-rounder pick. It does have some SVs.
A bit rolly just starting off the bat there.
A little spin to start off. Yeah, that's going to be pretty interesting to figure out how to accuracy.
Couple sweeps there too. Actually really odd on the snapping there.
Yeah, just from that initial bursty section, I feel like this might be a highly banned map in terms of players who are not comfortable with this speed.
I could potentially see people like practicing other charts over this, just because this is really one of the more dense and honestly like high accuracy based charts that you really do need to put a lot of practice into. And I think same amount of practice could be put into an SV chart. So it really just depends on a player's taste, I guess.
Definitely. Also, I guess it really depends on who your opponent is as well. You can do a lot of strategizing in this type of tournament, where you check out your opponent, you scope out his strengths and weaknesses, and you practice accordingly.
Just gonna put it out there that the qualification results could potentially help with that, so...
Maybe. Yeah, these patterns, though, and these SVs. That's going to be one hell of a pick to watch people fight over.
T-Deck actually coming out with no 200s there.
Get that score view 1SS. All right. And here's our 8th map of the map pool. It's a big one. It's a long one. It's one.
One.
Crystal.
Aha. Uh-huh.
It's just one. By Blackbuild. Yeah. The map artist is Octavia, and this is the longest map in the map pool. Like I said, it's a long one. Oh, there's gonna be so many puns to be made about this one. And they're just gonna be so easy to make. Anyways, it is 4 minutes and 39 seconds long, and very much a consistency map.
Really wish it was 4 minutes 31 seconds long.
That'd be a good one.
Ha. Ha ha. So this is actually... Wow, 4 minutes. But yeah, this is...
And you can already check the player's percentages. You have to be really paying attention because these long notes are slightly irregular and you're not really having a real big source of beep. You probably might not even be able to hear the song over talking.
So just based off the length of the song, you can already tell that it's really consistency-based, and you're really just going to need to stay on top of your accuracy throughout the entire chart. Also one of the lower star rating charts of the entire map pool. Actually, I suppose I can say this now, but this chart is longer than the tiebreaker.
Yes, the tiebreaker is shorter than this one.
This one.
Yes. I wonder if any players are going to actually ban this to be like, I don't want to fall asleep in the middle of a match. Like, as
well,
a... Oh, Tita breaks the long note. Oh, no.
Already losing focus. Too bored.
But seriously, you could definitely, like, unwarm up if you're not careful with how you're selecting your pick bans. Like, playing this and then going straight into, like...
That Camellia chart, maybe.
Yeah, Mushu no Sumu. That could be pronounce. A little bit of murder. Yeah, and definitely slightly earlier long note releases than you would expect, because there's little flams at the end of some of these phrases, and if you watch carefully, the long note releases before the actual next long note needs to be released.
Yeah, slightly.
So people probably have to watch out.
Well, if you're from Canada and you decide to pick this and you play Upscroll and Flashlight, we're not going to ban you from the tournament. Don't worry. So a lot of LNs coming in here, actually. I think mostly all the measures really involve LNs here.
Also, not to mention, this song is also very slow. It's only 136 BPM. We're only halfway done. Everyone feel free to close your eyes and take a nice long nap.
Take one nice long nap.
Why does this sound like a better Minecraft song?
So true.
This is like if Minecraft gets the Oriental mod pack. Oriental NPCs.
Whoever I play against, if neither of us bans this, and you pick this first against me, I'm gonna be so angry.
Everyone take that as a note. Don't ban this against iJinJin. Let him suffer.
I'm actually thinking about getting my name changed back. The iJinJin thing's kind of wearing off.
Still going.
Almost there.
Man, it's going to be so easy to lose concentration on this map. I zoned out probably like one too many times during this. I'm going to need to save some or else I'm going to run out of them.
I got to like start playing a laugh track on my phone every time someone makes a one pump. that rhymed too.
Aron Crystal says this is the map everyone will ignore. T-Dex keys stuck, which gave him the misses. Well, first things first, we'll be heading into our last normal map of the map pool, our ninth map. It will be First by Cilia. This is a one crystal map, and if you weren't filled up with enough noodles by now, we have a little bit more! Yay!
Blame one for the noodles.
Hashtag blame one. But don't blame one because it's boring. Blame one
be
first.
Boring
you have to blame one first.
Wow, okay.
But yeah, the star rating is only 2.42, as mentioned by people in chat. It's 2 minutes and 59 seconds long, so it is still pretty lengthy. And 190 BPM, so nothing to sneeze at there.
Halogens and Ravial. I don't know how to say that. I'm sorry. Freaking out, dude.
Definitely looks like the most tricky long note pick out of any that has been shown in the map pool so far. Yeah, definitely some fun releases to look out for. I don't think there's much to comment on. It's just lots of log notes, A lot of holding multiple log notes and managing all of their releases at the same time as well.
And speaking of managing releases, Juan failed to do that.
Yeah, he was the first to do that in this match. Even though it's his chart.
I thought he's supposed to be cheating on this one. He made the chart.
Oh, T-Deck also taking the miss. Breaking one of those long notes. I wonder if his keyboard's stuck again.
That's about it for this one.
Yep, now head into our tiebreaker for this group stage. We'll have Coinage by the Flashbulb. You thought it was gone, but it's come to haunt you all.
Yep, those so you don't
you haven't actually
have to pick
practiced
it, for,
it. You're going to have to put in that practice if you want to survive this.
Yeah, definitely.
Good
so
luck.
You really don't have to pick it for warm-ups anymore. Just try to get it for the tiebreaker.
Yeah, all you have to do is aim for that tiebreaker and you'll have Coinage to deal
yep,
with
so
all
get
over
hype.
Again.
Get hype, guys. I was after Coinage. but in all seriousness, it's not actually Coinage, it's Chloroplaskin. So,
okay, here's our actual tiebreaker map. We have Frenchitai by Frenzy Lee, or the mapper is Frenzy Lee. I lied. The map set is by Frenzy Lee, and this map is actually by Razora.
There you go. According to the notes we were given, you totally do not expect how hard this chart really is. So, I guess take notes.
Yep. And, your resident map pool selectors, T-Deck and Kamikaze, leave a nice little note for all of you. They say, "Welcome to Soft, ladies and gentlemen. We hope you enjoy Kami and T-Deck's wild ride." Smiley face.
Not exactly the nicest smiley face.
Yeah, it's one of the... I'll post it in Twitch chat. You'll see the smiley face pop up in a little bit, but that's what the smiley face looks like. But yeah, this being a soft tiebreaker, it features pretty much all skill sets. Bursts, jump screens, complex long notes.
SVs.
SVs! It's like something got hugged a little bit.
Oh, okay, that's pretty fun. This is pretty awkward. I really never thought I'd use that cup of coins again.
It was a beautiful usage. Since I was computer troubling out for most of the day, I think that was a pretty good surprise. Juan has to re-download the map. Ladies and gentlemen, remember, download the map pool beforehand. I don't think we had very many people who didn't, though. Thanks to all of the participants to help keep this moving as fast as possible and as smoothly as possible. But just another reminder, remember to download the map pools. Don't sight read.
Especially this map pool. It's a lot trickier than a lot of other map pools you might see.
You'll lose free songs if someone has put in any practice to some of the songs. Like Juan is just bugged. It's like T-Dex gonna solo this.
Oh, alright. Alright, yeah, it looks like T-Dex is gonna be playing on his own here.
Yep.
Coins
a little coins in the background.
It's
a little Gakkokurashi for all y'all who actually watched the series.
Sorry, I don't watch Chinese cartoons. I wouldn't understand.
No, this one's about zombies and people dying. So it was pretty cool. Except none of the main characters died. Wait, no, yes, one of them did. Spoilers, hashtag.
Spoilers.
Spoilers!
So, fairly straightforward streams here. A couple of low ones.
Little cute SVs. Ooh, some inverses.
I think that's the first time I've seen inverses this entire tournament.
Yeah. I think the other complex long notes have been just managing the release is fine, but there's never been any repeat long notes after them. Ooh, that was a nasty burst. That came out of nowhere.
Definitely the hardest thing we've seen this entire map for.
Those SVs might trip people up if they're not ready for them either.
Stream's not a... Yikes.
Oh, did stream...
Stream's not playing the map, we might have to...
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, the stream's not even playing the map.
Okay.
Cool.
Yeah, looks like we're gonna review this. Whoops.
Do you need me to be the background music instead?
Oh yeah, that's right, you're a god at singing.
Tataima te ano ko ga iu yo.
That Juan's back might actually play out the map now.
Maybe.
Juan curses stream.
Juan Crystal's saying he's going to hate this because the song is going to get stuck in his head. And yeah, it's definitely something that will get stuck in your head. Oh my god. I'm reminded, just based on the background having a bunch of characters in it, I'm just reminded of the Tricklash background.